You see, your choice will determine how you end. Welcome to today's DDRX. The prescription is check your choices. Deuteronomy 30:19. I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants may live. You know, we want to look at Paul and Demas. Paul had love for the word of God, and Demas loved the present world. You know, the level of the word of God in us determine our capacity to finish the race of life strong. Because in the word of God, we find healing, deliverance, direction, healing, power. Psalm 119 verse 105 says, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Revelation 12:11, and they overcame me by the blood of the lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they did not love their lives to the death. So Paul was a man of the word. His passion was unique. His focus was unmatched. In Philippians 3:8-11, yet indeed I also count all things lost for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my God, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and count them as rubbish that I may gain Christ, and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness which is from God by faith, that I may know him. Look at his choice, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering, being conformed to his death, if by any means I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. So Paul made it to the end because of his choice. In 2 Timothy 4:7-8, I have fought the good fight, Paul was writing. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but also to all who have loved his appearing. You see, your choice will determine how you end. Demas chose this present world. In 2 Timothy 4:10, for Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world, and has departed for Thessalonica, Christian for Galatians, Titus for Damascus. You see, worldliness is a matter of choice. 1 John 2:15-17, do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away, and the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever. Check your choices. Whether you love God, you love his word, or your love is for the world. Thank you.